Instead of illustrating the physics of a single spin, this section of animations depicts the physics of multiple dipoles, in this case, an array of 7x7 spins, again all viewed along the z-axis of B0 and projected into the xy plane. The top left panel depicts the rotating frame, while the top right panel depicts the lab frame. As before, all spins are initially aligned along z, and no transverse component, or arrow, is seen. When the 90-degree RF power is applied, as indicated by the top timeline, the spins spiral down and flip onto the transverse plane, which is visualized by the increased length of the rotating red arrows. Note how all the dipoles rotate in exact synchrony with the same phase. The bottom timeline depicts the signal received by a single loop antenna, which is the summation of signal from all 49 dipoles. In this simulation, there is a simple interaction of each dipole separately with the external environment, causing dissipation such that each dipole independently, slowly realigns to B0 while still precessing in circles. In reality, the mechanism involves an interaction of the spins with the underlying atomic lattice, or spin-lattice coupling. Note that while the dipoles realign, the magnitude of the transverse component, that is the length of the red vector, shortens. Now observe the bottom timeline. Since the signal is proportional to the length of the transverse component, the signal experiences an exponential decay superimposed on the sinusoidal waveform. The time for this decay to reach 37% of its maximal value is defined as the T1 time.